وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله الذي غرس شجرة الإيمان في قلوب عباده الأخيار وسقاها وغذاها بالعلوم النافعة والمعارف الصادقة واللهج بذكره آناء الليل والنهار وجعلها تؤتي أكلها وبركتها كل حين من النعم والخيرات الغزار وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له الواحد القهار الكريم الرحيم الغفار وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الرسول المصطفى المختار اللهم صل وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه البررة الأخيار أما بعد. In this episode, inshallah ta'ala, as I promised you last, in our last episode, that I'm going to speak about the thalathatu khisal, thalathu khisalin, three characteristics which were mentioned in the hadith al-nabawi, the prophetic hadith, hadith Anas ibn Malik in Sahihain, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned three characteristics that if a person receives and gains these three characteristics, that they will attain halawat al-iman. That they will attain halawat al-iman, the sweetness of al-iman. So let's start with the first one, al-khaslatul ula, the first characteristics. Mahabbatullahi ta'ala wa rasuli, loving Allah and His Messenger. The first one, brothers and sisters, which is to love Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Let's start with that one, and then we go to the Prophet. So mahabbatullahi, let's start with that one. Loving Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said about mahabbatullahi, loving Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. He says, المنزلة التي فيها تنافس المتنافسون وإليها شخص العاملون وإلى علمها شمر السابقون وعليها تنافى المحبون وبروح نسيمها تروح العابدون فيقوت القلوب وغذاء الأرواح وقرة العيون وهي الحياة التي من حرمها فهو من جملة الأموات والنور الذي من فقده فهو في بحار الظلمات والشفاء الذي من عدمه حلت بقلبه جميع الأسقام واللذة التي من لم يظفر بها فيعشوه كله هموم والآلام. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, the kalam that he said is baligh, it's eloquence at the highest level. And he said this statement of his in his kitab Madarij al-Salikin rahimahullah, the third volume, page 6. He says that this is a station, a position, التي فيها تنافس المتنافسون. Those who are competing, they competed towards. وإليها شخص العاملون. The ones who are working hard, this is the station they work towards and they saw and they loved and they wanted to be part of. وإلى علمها شمر السابقون. And the knowledge of those who preceded. This is where they lifted their garments and they ran towards it. They charged towards it. وعليها تفان المحبون وبروح نسيمها تروح العابدون. This is, it's a station that the worshippers, the ones who know Allah تبارك وتعالى, all work towards, which is محبة الله, loving Allah. فيقوت القلوب وغذاء الأرواح وقرة العيون. It is that which brings warmth to the eyes. It gives life to the soul. It gives nutrition to the heart. وهي الحياة التي, and it is the life. من حرمها فهو من جملة الأموات. That person is from the dead people if he's prevented from this loving Allah تبارك وتعالى. والنور الذي من فقده, it is the light that anyone who loses it doesn't get this light. فهو في بحار الظلمات, he's in the oceans of darkness. والشفاء الذي من عدمه, and it is the cure, the person who's not given it. حلت بقلبه جميع الأسقام, all of illnesses will fall on his heart. وَاللَّذَّةُ الَّتِي, it is the sweetness, it is the joy, that مَنْ لَمْ يَظْفَرْ بِهَا, the one who doesn't attain it. فَيَعْشُوهُ كُلُّ هُمُومٍ وَالْآلَمْ, every depression and distress, that he will live that life. انتهى كلامه, that's the end of the statement of Ibn al-Qayyim. الله أكبر. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Qur'an, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَتَّخِذُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ أَنْدَادًا يُحِبُّونَهُمْ كَحُبِّ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أشد حبا لله. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ from amongst the people are those مَنْ يَتَّخِذُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ, they take besides Allah تبارك وتعالى أندادا ند, someone that they make equal to Allah. يُحِبُّونَهُمْ, they love them, كَحُبِّ اللَّهِ, the way they love Allah. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, verily the ones who believe, are what? أشد حبا لله, they love Allah the most. فَالْمَحَبَّةُ الصَّادِقَةِ, the true love, brothers and sisters, it is what? هِيَ الَّتِي تَبْعَثُ عَلَى عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ وَحْدَهِ, it pushes the person to worshipping Allah alone. بَلْ رَاذَا وَالْمُسَارَعَةَ فِي إِرْضَاءِ الْمَحْبُوبِ, it just works towards pleasing Allah تبارك وتعالى. شيخ الإسلام ابن القيم, شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية, he says, فَكُلَّ مَزْدَادَ الْقَلْبُ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ ازْدَادَ لَهُ عُبُودِيَّةً, وَكُلَّمَ ازْدَادَ لَهُ عُبُودِيَّةً ازْدَادَ لَهُ حُبًّا وَحُرِّيَّةً عَمَّا سِوَهِ. The Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he says, every time the love of Allah increases in a person's heart, فَكُلَّمَ ازْدَادَ الْقَلْبُ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ, every time the love of Allah increases in a person's heart, ازْدَادَ لَهُ عُبُودِيَّةً, what will increase for you is worshipping Allah. And the more you love Allah, the more you worship Him. They're connected. The lesser your love of Allah, when it reduces, your ibadah, you'll see it will reduce. Okay? وَكُلَّمَ ازْدَادَ لَهُ عُبُودِيَّةً, and every time your ibadah for Allah increases, subhanahu wa ta'ala, ازْدَادَ لَهُ حُبًّا وَحُرِّيَّةً عَمَّا سِوَهُ. Every time your worship for Allah increases, your love of Allah means that it's increased. And guess what? وَحُرِّيَّةً عَمَّا سِوَهُ, you will start to feel free from everything other than Allah. You will start to attain freedom from everything else. Brothers and sisters, a lot of people are in shackles, right? Because of their desires or other people. You see, but no. The one who has the love of Allah in his heart, and his love of Allah increases, what happens is that he starts to become free from the people. That he doesn't have that obsession over worldly things. He doesn't have it. His heart is more connected to Akhirah. And the sign of a person's love for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is, as al-Imam Hafidh al-Hakami says in his kitab Ma'arij al-Qabul, he says, تَقْدِيمُ مَحَابِّهِ وَإِنْ خَالَفَتْ هَوَهِ, the sign to know that you love Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, أَمَ عَلَامَةُ حُبِّ الْعَبْدِ لِرَبِّهِ, he's talking about how do you want, if you want to know that you love Allah more than anything, how can you know? تَقْدِيمُ مَحَابِّهِ وَإِنْ خَالَفَتْ هَوَهِ, you give precedence to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, the one you love, over your own desires. وَبُغْضُ مَا يَبْغَضُ رَبُّهُ, and the person starts to hate that which Allah hates. وَبُغْضُ مَا يَبْغُضُ رَبُّهُ, you start to hate that which your Lord hates. وَإِنْ مَالَ إِلَيْهِ هَوَى, even if your desires is inclined to it. وَمُوَالَاتُ مَنْ وَالَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولَهُ, and you start to take allegiance and give allegiance to wala, to the ones Allah and His Messenger give allegiance to. وَمُعَادَاتُ مَنْ عَادَاهُ, and you show hate and animosity to the one Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gives hate towards. وَاتِّبَاعُ رَسُولِهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, and following the Messenger صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Okay? وَاقْتِفَاءُ أَثَرِهِ وَقَبُولُ هُدَاهُ, and you tread on the path of the Prophet صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, and you accept his guidance. وَكُلُّ هَذِهِ الْعَلَامَاتِ شُرُوطٌ فِي الْمَحَبَّةِ, and all of these are, you know, alamat, signs for the prerequisite, the condition for what? In love. Brothers and sisters, asbab tahsil al-mahabba, Ibn Taymiyyah explained that in great details, rahimahullah. Yani means and ways to attain the love of Allah. How do you, I want to love Allah, how can I do that? Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he mentions it rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'ah, and he goes in great details, inshallah ta'ala. I'm going to read his kalam on you, rahimahullah, in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, the first volume, page 95. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he says, اعلم نو أن محركات القلوب إلى الله ثلاثة. There are three things that move the heart. Look at this, pay attention to this. There are three things that move the heart. If you want your heart to start moving and start working and start, يعني, because remember, the heart sleeps and it becomes dead and it doesn't do anything. What are the things that move the heart and start making the person become enthusiastic and etc.? What are they? Al-mahabbatu wal-khawfu wal-raja. These are three factors that generally, even speaking, they are min muharrakat al-qulub. For example, somebody when he loves someone, he starts to work towards something. When someone fears something, that it also has an effect on his heart. لا شك ولا ريب. And when he has hope of something, that there's also his heart starts moving. So these three, when they're all there, it's the best. But all of them are there. Are they the same? No, they're not all the same. ولذلك look what he says, Ibn Taymiyyah. He says, اعلم أن محركات القلوب إلى الله ثلاثة المحبة والخوف والرجاء وأقواها المحبة. The strongest one is love. وهي مقصودة تراد لذاتها. Love is the one that's intended in and within itself. لأنها تراد في الدنيا والآخرة, because it's intended in his dunya and in the hereafter. بخلاف الخوف, but fear no. فإنه يزول في الآخرة. The day of judgment, there's no fear. There's no such thing as al-khawf يوم القيامة. That's what Allah says in the Qur'an. ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. إذن fear doesn't exist in the hereafter. Like in love, yes, it exists in the hereafter. والخوف المقصود منه الزجر والمنع. The khawf, there's something intended from it. It's not intended in and within itself. It's intended for what? الزجر والمنع من الخروج عن الطريق. It is to stop someone, prevent them from what? From يعني leaving the path that Allah sanctions, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فالمحبة love. Ibn Taymiyyah's kalam is what I'm saying and I'm explaining. فالمحبة Ibn Taymiyyah said love. تلقى العبد في السير إلى محبوبه وعلى قدر ضعفها وقوتها يكون سيره إليه. Love is the thing, brothers and sisters, in which the slave, he goes towards, he treads towards, إلى محبوبه, to the one he loves. وعلى قدر ضعفها وقوتها, and in accordance to its strength and its weakness, يكون سيره إلى الله. أما يكون سيره إلي. Your traversing to Allah تبارك وتعالى is in accordance to that strength and that weakness. If you're very strong, you go fast and you keep going. But if you're weak, you take your time. والخوف يمنعه أن يخرج عن الطريق المحبوب. But fear, what does it do? Fear prevents you from leaving that path. So love is that one thing that pushes you to Allah تبارك وتعالى. It makes you go towards Allah. And again, it's in accordance to على قدر ضعفها وقوتها. It's in accordance to the strength of it and the weakness of it in the way that the person goes to Allah. لكن what does fear play? What's the role of fear? Fear is the thing that stops you from leaving that road and going left or right. Fear, that's what it does. والخوف يمنع أن يخرج عن طريق المحبوب. It stops the person from leaving the path. What about hope? والرجاء يقوده. رجاء is the thing that guides you, shows you the path, and makes you understand this is the path. Okay, don't confuse it with this. فهذا أصل عظيم يجب أن شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية يسأل فهذا أصل عظيم يجب على كل عبد أن يتنبه له. This is a very strong foundation that every single person should be aware of and know. فإنه لا تحصل له العبودية. You will not attain عبودية, servitude, بدونه, without them, without these three. المحبة and الخوف and الرجاء. وكل أحد يجب أن يكون عبدا لله لا لغيره. Everyone should be a slave to Allah تبارك وتعالى and no one else. فإن قيل, if it said, فالعبد في بعض الأحيان قد لا يكون عنده محبة. If it said, sometimes love might not be there and might not be present in the slave. تبعث على طلب محبوبه, in looking to do what he's, the one he loves, requests. فأي شيء يحرك القلوب. What is it then that's going to move the heart? قلنا, we will say to you, يحركها شيئا. Ibn Taymiyyah asks a question. He said, فإن قيل, if this question is posed to us, and someone says, فالعبد في بعض الأحيان, that the slave sometimes, قد لا يكون عنده محبة. Love may not be present in a situation. تبعث على طلب محبوبي, in looking to do what pleases his lover, the one he loves. فأي شيء يحرك القلوب. What can now give the movement of the heart? قلنا, we will say, يحركها شيئان. Two things can move the heart. كثرة الذكر للمحبوب, remembering him a lot. لأن كثرة ذكره تعلق القلوب به. If you always remember him, it will connect your heart to him. ولهذا أمر الله عز وجل بذكر الكثير. That's why Allah commanded us to remember him a lot. قال تعالى الله says يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا وسبحوه بكرة واصيلا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا those of you who believe اذكروا الله remember Allah واذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا remember Allah a lot وسبحوه exalt him سبحانه وتعالى بكرة واصيلا. The second one is ومطالعة آلائه ونعمائه. Looking and pondering and contemplating over the blessings that he has bestowed upon you. Keep looking at what he gave you. Look, he gave you this. He gave you this. He bestowed this upon you. And then he brings the ayah that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, فَذُكُرُوا آلَاءَ اللَّهِ. Remember the blessing of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Why? لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. You will attain success from it. Also, he brings the other ayah. وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. That there's no blessing that you have except that is from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And he also brings the other ayah. وَأَسْبَغَ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعَمَهُ ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنَةً. Allah has poured over you and has given you subhanahu wa ta'ala his blessings. ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنَةً. Externally and internally. Also that he brings the other ayah that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala he says. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you sit down and you count the blessings of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, you'll never be able to put a figure on it. You can't say Allah's blessings on me is about 2,000. He's given me 2,000 blessings. You can't say that. It's more than what you can think of. Then Ibn Taymiyyah, he said, فَإِذَا ذَكَرَ الْعَبْدُ مَا أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ بِهِ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ تَسْخِيرِ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ وما فيها من الأشجار والحيوان وما أسبغ عليهم من النعم الباطنة من الإيمان وغيره فلا بد أن يثير ذلك عنده باعثا وكذلك الخوف تحركه مطالعة آيات الوعيد والزجر والعرض والحساب ونحوه وكذلك الرجاء يحرك مطالعة الكرم والحلم والعفو. ابن تيمية he says, if the person looks at the blessings of Allah تبارك وتعالى that he has bestowed upon him, like for example, من تسخير السماء والأرض, the sky and the heavens, look at it. The rain that comes from it. وما فيها من الأشجار والحيوان. Look at the trees that are on this earth that Allah تبارك وتعالى placed on it. Look at the animals, the different types of animals. وما أسبغ عليهم من النعم, the blessings that he has bestowed upon all of them. الباطنة, the inner and the outer, من الإيمان. وغيره فلا بد. With all of that, when a person looks at it and ponders over it, فلا بد, it is going to be. أن يثير ذلك عنده باعثا. This is going to push, brothers and sisters. What is it going to push? It's going to push the person to loving Allah تبارك وتعالى. وكذلك الخوف. And also fear. تحرك مطالعة آيات الوعيد. When the person looks at the punishments of Allah that are mentioned in the Qur'an and the way Allah destroys nations, سبحانه وتعالى. And when the person ponders on what? والعرض والحساب, Allah's accountability. He ponders on all of that. It will push him towards loving Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. وَكَذَلِكَ الرَّجَاءُ. And hope. When the person, يعني, he looks at that, يُحَرِّكُ مُطَالَعَةَ الْكَرَمِ وَالْحِلْمِ وَالْعَفْوِ. He looks at Allah's mercy, Allah's forbearance, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's generosity. This will all push him towards الرجاء. My beloved brothers and sisters, I'm going to conclude inshallah ta'ala a statement that أحد علماء رحمه الله he mentions. And he has told the truth when he said so. He sent a letter to one of his brothers and he said the following to him. He said, أما بعد, to proceed. يا أخي فقد أصبح بنا من نعم الله ما لا نحصيه مع كثرة ما نعصيه فما ندري أيها نشكر أجميل ما ظهر أم قبيح ما ستر. الله أكبر. He says, my beloved brother, فَقَدْ أَصْبَحَ بِنَا مِنْ نِعَمِ اللَّهِ. We have received this morning blessings of Allah تبارك وتعالى مَا لَا نُحْصِيهِ, that which we cannot put a number to it. مَعَ كَثْرَةِ مَا نَعْصِيهِ, with all of the sins that we are committing and the crimes that we're committing, with all of that, Allah تبارك وتعالى, He is still سبحانه وتعالى, He's pouring onto us His blessings. فَمَا نَدْرِي, we do not know. أيهما نشكر, which one should we thank him for, subhanahu wa ta'ala? Which one should we thank him for? For the blessings that he's given us, أجميل ما ظهر, the beauty that Allah تبارك وتعالى made apparent, Am qabihu ma satar, or the evil in which he concealed for us. Which one should we thank him for, subhanahu wa ta'ala? I'm going to stop there, inshallah ta'ala. Next, inshallah ta'ala, episode, I will speak about mahabbat rasulillah, loving the messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, and shaitan and Allah and his messenger are both free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdi, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Ramadan with AMAU. Make this the best Ramadan you've ever had by joining our exclusive online community with regular private classes, digital resources, weekly accountability sessions, and daily Qur'an gatherings. This is one opportunity you definitely do not want to miss. So sign up now at amau.org/Ramadan, and we look forward to welcoming you on the other side.